For this problem, we have to find out what is the internal force at C, D, E, different location, different point on this simply supported beam. So what we are going to do is actually do several cuts. So let's do the internal force at C first. So which means we are going to do the cut at C. So how about we try to name it as 1-1 cut? So again, I highly recommend you to use the cards, credit cards, blaster cards, or your calculator, your cell phone to help you make a decision which side you want to pick as your FBD. So now let's take a look at here. You can choose this side as your FBD, or you can flip your card, choose another side. Do you have a decision now which side you want to pick as your FBD? Obviously, the simple and easy one, right? So what you are going to do is trying to redraw the FBD you see here. And the reaction force at A is given 15.75 kilonewton go up. And then we are going to have 3 internal force. For this problem, since we don't have horizontal load, so which means we are going to have a shear force at location C, and we are going to have bending moment at C. So what we are going to do right now is try to use equilibrium equation to find out all the internal force at C. So if we were trying to summarize the force in the y direction, we are going to find out the shear function at C. It will equals to the 15.75 kilonewton. If we were trying to summarize moment, again, I highly recommend you to summarize moment at the cutting location here, so that even if you mess up with the shear force, the arrow is not going to carry on. So now let's take a look. We had negative 15.75 multiply the dimension. So the distance here will be 1 meter. So you can find out MC is going to be 15.75 kilonewton meter. So we down the location at C, which means we are going to do the cut at D location. So firstly, try to draw a vertical line passing through D. So how about we say this is going to be 2-2 cut. And again, try to use your card, your calculator, to help you make a decision. Are you planning to use this side as your FBD, or you want to pick another side? So I would recommend you to use left-hand side so that we can avoid the distributed load. So which means we are going to redraw the second FBD. So we are having 12 kilonewton acting down at 1.5 meter. And then we had a reaction force A, which is 15.75 kilonewton. And then the cutting location, you can see it's going to be 1.5 plus 1. So which means it's going to be 2.5 meter. And at the cutting location, again, we are going to have shear force and bending moment. So now what we are going to do, again, use equilibrium equation. Let's try to summarize the force in the y direction. And we can see we had 12 going down. V equals to 0. So which means D is equals to 3.75 kilonewton. Let's try to summarize moment at cutting location again. So we are going to have 15.75, which will multiply 2.5 meter, and then we are going to have 12, multiply this distance, which will be 1, and plus, and D equals to 0. So we can try to solve the MD that is equals to 27.375 whole Newton meter. So now we have to figure out what is the internal force at E, which means we are going to do another cut. That's going to come through the E location. So how about we name this as 3-3 cut. So now, what we are going to do is still use your paper to decide. Are you going to use this side as your FBD or you are planning to use another side? So I think the paper or the card will help you make a decision, right? We are going to pick this side as our FBD. So on this side, we can see we had BY 23.25 kilonewton go up, and then we also see some distributed load. Did you see that? Don't forget about this. Okay, so now what we are going to do is try to draw the internal force and bending moment. Before we proceed to write down our equilibrium equation, we have to draw all the dimensions, right? Because we have to simplify this rectangle distributed load. Okay, so now let's take a look the dimension. Here from the picture, you can see is 1.5 meter. So when we try to simplify this load, it will be the area of this rectangle. So that's going to be 9 multiply 1.5. And then, since we get everything, which means we can try to use the equilibrium equation, let's try to summarize the force in a y direction. And we are going to have VE minus 30.5 plus 23.25 equals to 0. So which means we can solve the internal force at E will be 9.75 kilonewton. What is negative means our assumption was wrong. It should go in down here. So if we were trying to summarize the moment at the cutting location, we can try to find out the moment. So we can try to solve ME.